Carlos, we give you our many congratulations for surely what is one of the best wins of the eight wins that you've managed this season.
Of course, we knew how tough would be that game. But it's true that we wanted to change the dynamic of the last two results, and especially the fact that we play here at home. We wanted to show a very competitive mentality today, because for me, the demandings, the physical demanding, the technical demanding, and the mental demanding of this game was too high. And we know that we have to work very hard today to achieve one result at that one.
Can you let us in a little bit, Carlos, on your shape plans today, the method that you used, because clearly West Bromwich Albion have been candidates for promotion. They've started very strongly. How do you plan to get in behind them and stop them defensively?
First of all, you never know what is going to happen in the game, but before to play that game, I was thinking that the fact that we didn't have Hoggy in the middle of the pitch we were thinking to compensate it with Turton as a right wing back and to be a strong in defence, because against this team, as soon as you are not strong in defence and they start to win the game, it's more difficult to take something positive. So the idea was to be defensively very solid, and after using the space that they gave today to us, because it was very difficult to play short because they are a very aggressive team. But it's true, like, that they are very aggressive. Sometimes you can find some spaces in behind to surprise. So the idea was to have the mentality, to have the understanding of the game. But for me, the players understand well the game. And after, the key is not understanding of the game. The key is to impose and to do and to make what exactly the game is demanding to us. In some moments we did, in some moments we couldn't break the press and we couldn't create enough opportunities. I think in the second half we were very inorganized in defense. We fixed some points that for me were important, because they created some problems with movement on behind of one of the strikers to the right side in the first half. We didn't stop enough well the crosses in the first half. That's why they start to have the feeling that they could create more clear chances. But I was watching that in the second half, the team were dominating better the game in defense without have the option to play a lot in attack. But when you are winning the game, if you defend well, always you are going to have opportunities in the counter-attack, especially one thing like that one that are going to be even more aggressive. Always you can have options with the movements in behind, using the space that they leave in the back of the central backs. And I think it was clear that we had a couple of good opportunities to can score the second goal. We didn't do, and we have to compete until the end in the way that we competed today to get the 3 points.
It was another early goal. Another early Daniel Sinani goal, great for the home fans to see one. But concentration, focus, communication was so key for so long for your players. How pleased are you with that particular function, that they stayed concentrated on your plans for the whole of the game that was still to unravel in front of them?
We knew that as soon as you lost the concentration 2 seconds against this team, you are going to suffer the consequence of the losing of the focus or concentration, because they are one team very aggressive, that they move very fast from defense to attack. They have 3 strikers that everyone has a very good level. Of course, they are one of the best strikers that they can have in the league. So it was key to manage this concentration. For me, the team did really well, because in many opportunities they could use the space in our back of defenders, but for me, the concentration of the central backs were brilliant today. The aggressive in the middle of the pitch in some moments was very good too. And it's true that it was difficult to impose our style, was difficult to play short. But sometimes you need to play depending where the spaces are going to be. And today the spaces were clear in behind. But even if we didn't use enough times to this space to kind of balance more the game. But the mentality of the players were, for me, brilliant. And without the mentality, it would be impossible to achieve this, what the achievement of the team today.
Take some congratulations yourself and your fellow coaches, Carlos, because you've beaten a very good team, having clearly done extra homework on West Bromwich Albion. On individuals today, I want to ask you about Scott High and his continuing maturity, but also Danny Ward. It was very noticeable that even though seconds before he'd missed a chance, which would have put Huddersfield Town 2-0 ahead, you were still quick to thank him and congratulate him on his contribution when you brought him off as a substitute.
For me, the game that Danny Ward did today was a very good game because it was not easy to play, to be competing for all the balls, to after to keep even some balls and to make one hard work that he was doing for me fantastic in the game. I did have, my plan was not to play with him as a striker, to use more scenarios as a striker, but watching the work that Danny Ward was doing today, we didn't change and we were keeping playing with him and scenario on the side. And for me, it was very important to use him making from impossible balls to keep possible balls that allow the team to attack and to recover a little bit more and to go to offensive half and take some throw-ins. That is true that we didn't manage well the throw-ins in attack, but allow us to start to balance the game and don't be suffering defense a lot.
And Scott High, you asked him to do a job which involved a lot of responsibility. He's a young man, maturing quickly, but how did you think he carried the responsibility of the role you gave him today against a very good opponent?
I think the last two games of Scott High allow us to have the full confidence in him, because for me against Cardiff he did a very good game. After he wasn't training with the team during international break because he was playing with Scotland. The second game with Scotland for me was a brilliant game. He was managing very well and especially playing the position as a position midfielder. I always think that Scott High is a player that the best of him can arrive when he has a space to attack because he's a running player. But today he was playing with this maturity in the middle of the pitch, and for me, O'Brien and him did a very good and complicated work both, because it was necessary to win all the battles in the middle of the pitch to don't provoke, to stop their attacks and try to create some attack of our team. And I know that Scott High, when he receives the ball in a good body shape, always have a very good connection with the striker, and we can use him and he can help a lot of the team to achieve performances like the one that we achieved today.
Can you enlighten us a little bit on John Russell finally, Carlos? We've been introduced to him properly at home for the first time today. What kind of a role can we expect him to play in the team in terms of his position and his long-term influence? He's obviously physically very impressive. Is he an attacking or a defensive midfielder for those who have not seen him in the B team?
He is both things. Being honest, he's one player similar to Scott High, similar in term of that he can play in both positions, but I will prioritize more him as a positional midfielder more than as attacking midfielder. But being honest, he has resources to play high on the pitch and he has resources to be more in defense. It's true that he's a player that still needs to adapt to the tempo of the competition, but of course now without Ho in the next week and without Vallejo in the next week, he's going to be one of the possibilities in one of the options that for sure we are going to watch playing even more minutes than he was playing today.
Many congratulations, Carlos. As always, we appreciate you talking to us live on BBC Radio Leeds, and especially after today, I think the whole town's looking forward to Queen's Park Rangers away on Wednesday night. Thank you.
Okay, thanks to you.